यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम् अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधूनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे.
My dear loving children, I am before you with a very fantastic set of words. And those words are, you know, you must have seen the railway line concomitantly going to each other. Does not touch. If it touches, no rail can ply on it. No rail train can run on it. The words are utopia, U-T-O-P-I-A, and dystopia, D-Y-S-T-O-P-I-A. I again repeat the word utopia and dystopia. हिंदी में बोला जाता है कि यही आ सटके रहे अली गुलाब के फूल अहियों बौरी बसंत कब इन डारिन में फूल. We always, you know, imagine something which is not worth realizing in our life. See, this video is exclusively dedicated to the children. Normally it is said that you labor hard, otherwise nothing will come to you unless until you have toiled. If you have not burnt midnight oil, you will not get to success. Why it is said so? By our parents, our great grandparents. It is said because nothing comes for a free. Nothing comes without hard work. And mind you, if you get something without hard work, that is very doubtful, and that is very much ephemeral. Ephemeral means short-lived. Either ya to churai hui cheez hogi, that does not belong to you. So now let me come back to the word utopia. U-T-O-P-I-A, utopia. Yeah, you must have seen many teachers, you know, rebuking students. If you don't labor hard today, you should not be in a dreamland that you will get a good success or you will ever pass with good marks. Utopia means an imaginary world which does not exist, but still you realize that. You still feel like that it's within the reach. Something very impractical, not to be attained or achieved, still you long for it. You crave for it. You desire for it. You fantasize. बहुत सारे लोगों के बारे में सुनते होंगे कि इसको मार दो उसको मार दो, मरने के बाद फिर ऊपर जाओगे तो आपको 72 हूर मिलेगी, ऐसा भी बोलते हैं. What is this? This is nothing but an explanation to allure some misguided youths or the poor children for the vested interest of certain criminals, the terrorists. You must have heard about the ongoing scenario in Jammu and Kashmir, where Laskar-e-Toyba and Hizbul Mujahideen, you know, they have instigated the local population of Jammu and Kashmir, and they are, you know, alluring poor family children that you come and you sacrifice, you enter in the process of jihad and kill all the infidels while in the process of attaining that success story of jihad. If you get killed, you will go to the top floor. Upar mein koi baitha hua hai with so many girls waiting for you to entertain, and they are in 72 in numbers. Just imagine kitne bade khayali pulao. Isi bolte hai khayali pulao. Ye jo utopia word hai na, iska literal translation karte ho hindi mein to kya hoga? Khayali pulao. Kya matlab hai? आप मन में खूब बढ़िया बढ़िया पुलाव खा लो, यू नो. सो दैट इज व्हाट यूटोपिया मीन, समथिंग विच इज नॉट इन रियलिटी बट यू आर मेड टू बिलीव दैट इज this could be achieved. That is there. So that is called utopia. As far as the dictionary explanation of the word goes, which I have noted down for your benefit, is an often imaginary place or a state of utter perfection and happiness. हम लोग हिंदू धर्म के अंदर भी बोलते हैं ना स्वर्ग जाएंगे, इस धरती पे अच्छे कर्म करोगे तो स्वर्ग जाएंगे. हमारे पूर्वज लोग ऐसी ऐसी बातें क्यों बोलते थे? स्वर्ग जाने का मतलब कि आपका इस जन्म में कोई बुरा कर्म नहीं होना चाहिए. हमारे जो फोर फादर्स थे वो बहुत ही समझदार और नेक इंसान, वो आतंकवादियों की तरह नहीं कि लोगों को मारो काटो उसके बाद ऊपर बेहतर और मिलेंगे ना. यहाँ पे भी इस धरती पे भी अच्छे कर्म करो, कभी बुरे कम किसी के लिए मत करो. हर कोई, तभी तो इंडिया का पॉलिसी है वसुधैव कुटुंबकम, इंटायर वर्ल्ड इज माय फैमिली, दे आर जस्ट लाइक गेस्ट्स. वी शुड ट्रीट यू नो एनीवन हु कम्स टू आवर हाउस टू सीक सम हेल्प, वी शुड ट्रीट देम एज दे आर यू नो एंजल, दे आर गॉड हु हैज कम टू योर डोरस्टेप. हमारी कल्चर सभ्यता भी ऐसी सिखाती है कि घर पे कोई आए तो उनको पानी पूछो, बैठाओ आदर से, घर पे बैठाओ. वो हमारी संस्कृति है. आवर यू नो द ग्रेट ट्रेडिशनल वैल्यू सिस्टम विच वी हैव इनहेरिटेड फ्रॉम सेंचुरीज टूगेदर दैट हैज इम्बाइब्ड अस टू लर्न गुड वैल्यूज व्हाइल यू आर लिविंग. मरने के बाद नहीं, अब मरने के बाद अभी अच्छा करोगे तो मरने के बाद भी अच्छा होगा, हमारे पूर्वजों ने सिखाया. और यही वैल्यूज होनी चाहिए. व्हेन यू कम फ्रॉम आउटसाइड देर आर बिग होर्डिंग्स एट द एयरपोर्ट, इनक्रेडिबल इंडिया, अतुल्य भारत, अद्वितीय भारत, क्यों बोला जाता है? ऐसी कल्चर कहीं नहीं है वर्ल्ड में. एवरीवन एंड एवरीवेयर इट इज पे एंड पार्क. पैसे दोगे तो काम होगा, नहीं दोगे तो नहीं होगा, एज सिंपल एज दैट. बट हियर इन आवर कल्चर आवर ट्रेडिशंस आर नॉट यूटोपियन इन नेचर, इट इज वेरी मच प्रैग्मेटिक. दिस यूटोपियन इज इम्प्रैक्टिकल. अब देखो क्या है, एन इमेजिनरी, ऐसे ही ख्वाली ख्याली पुलाव, इमेजिनरी प्लेस. आई विल गो टू ए पैलेस वेयर यू नो good food, nothing doing, only sleeping. When I come out of it, I'll go to a river or a pond. All of the servants will be waiting for me, you know, that kind of imagination. State of utter perfection, jahan kuch bhi kharabi nahi hai, sab kuch badhiya hi badhiya hai. And happiness, koi dukh nahi, koi takleef nahi hai. Wahan koi corona virus nahi hai. Sab balle balle. That is called utopia. U-T-O-P-I-A. Now, let us find its uses. Don't be under the impression that without laboring hard, you are going to get success. If you think so, that without hard work, you are going to success, you are going to get success, that is your utopian concept. Ye tumhara khayali pulav hai. Utopian concept. यूटोपियन मीन्स जो ख्वाबों में होता है, जो रियलिटी नहीं होता, विच इज मिस्टिकल इन नेचर, विच इज इमेजिनरी बट नॉट इन रियलिटी, विच इज नॉट प्रैक्टिकल, दैट इज नॉट ए प्रैग्मेटिक अप्रोच. प्रैक्टिकल से ही प्रैग्मेटिक बना है. विच इज नॉट फंक्शनल, विच इज जस्ट नोशनल, विच इज जस्ट इमेजिन, दैट इज नॉट टू बी हैपन, नॉट टू हैपन इन रियलिटी, दैट इज कॉल्ड यूटोपियन कॉन्सेप्ट. इट्स एन स्टेट ऑफ यूटोपिया. जैसे बोलता है ना कभी कभी, अरे यार अभी उसको छोड़ दो, ही इज इन स्टेट ऑफ यूटोपिया, अभी लंबी लंबी फेंकने में लगा हुआ है, लंबी लंबी सोच रहा है. दैट स्टेट ऑफ अफेयर इज कॉल्ड बीइंग इन स्टेट ऑफ यूटोपिया, एन इमेजिनरी वर्ल्ड, द वर्ल्ड विच इज नॉट टू बी, विच इज नॉट एग्जिस्टेंट, विच इज नॉट इन रियालिटी, केवल ख्वाबों में. एक गाना सुना ना, चांद सी महबूबा हो ऐसा मैंने सोचा था, अपने देखने में काला कलूटा हो लेकिन सपना देख रहा है चांद सी महबूबा हो ऐसा मैंने सोचा था। कभी कभी देखते हो पुराने गीतों में इस शायरी जो लिखते हैं, जो स्क्रिप्ट लिखते हैं, मैं चांद तारे तोड़ के ले आऊंगा, पता चला कि चार कदम चलते हैं चार सीढ़ी चढ़ ले तो दम फूल जाता है, चांद तारे तोड़ के ले आऊंगा। व्हाट आर दीज राइटिंग्स? दीज राइटिंग्स आर यूटोपियन राइटिंग्स। इमेजिन ए सिनेरियो वेयर समबडी इज इमेजिनिंग, आई डोंट हैव टू डू एनीथिंग, सिंपली गो देयर एंड लाइफ इज सो कोजी, यू नो, ऑल ब्यूटिफुल थिंग्स अराउंड, लॉट ऑफ प्लेंटी ऑफ गुड थिंग्स टू ईट अराउंड, यू नो, यू आर जस्ट गोइंग टू डिवॉर। मैंने पिछले दिनों एक वर्ड बताया था, वोरेसियस, तो दैट हैज सिम्बॉलिक मीनिंग विथ यूटोपियन ऑल्सो। यह एक ऐसा जमाना आएगा, जैसे बोलते हैं ना, रामचंद्र का गे सियाप वैसा कलयुग आएगा, हंस चुनेगा दाना कौवा मोती चुन चुन खाएगा। नो ए दैट इज इम्प्लिसिट, यू नो, एक्सप्लेनेशन दैट इट टाइम विल कम व्हेन इडियट्स विल टेक द मोस्ट बेनिफिट ऑफ द एग्जिस्टिंग रिसोर्सेज ऑफ द सोसाइटी। दैट कुड बी अ रियलिटी, बट इफ यू सिंपली फैंटेसाइज थिंग्स to your benefit, that is utopia, that is something which is impractical, hardly to be realized. Now let us see some of the words which are there, which are approximately near to its meaning. Camelot. What is Camelot? You must have heard about the King Arthur. That was a palace, you know, that was all fictional, written by John Hulton. So the palace of King Arthur was so splendid, so massive, so majestic, you know, that no soldier, nobody was, you know, impoverished. No war, no one was in the state of want. Everyone was in a state of plenty. That was their feeling. So, if that is the scenario, it means it is all the state of utopia. Cockaigne, C-O-C-K-A-I-G-N-E. It was a concept, you know, of medieval period when you don't have to do anything. Everything is in a splendid quantity and quantum. You simply have to relish and enjoy, which was not to be. That is something utopian. Same is Eden, heaven. As I told you, in our Hindu mythology also, the concept of heaven is there. Eden is the another version of heaven. Elysium, Empyrean, these are all, you know, utopian concept. It all resembles a palace where no one is unhappy, everyone is happy, everyone has to do nothing. Virtually they are free roaming, they are just gossiping, and they are having lots of thing in form of, you know, choices to eat, what to eat, what to leave, you know, they are in a state of quandary. So that is the thinking, that is the highest state of utopia. Fantasyland, something, you know, you must have seen that somebody is fantasizing, glorifying unnecessarily, which is not in existence, which is not in reality, which is not in practical shape. That is called fantasyland. Tomorrow I shall go there and somebody has booked a 5-star hotel. It's some farmer who is grazing with a cow. He is talking to his fellow grazer. No, somebody of mine, friend of mine, he has booked a 5-star hotel in Delhi. I'll fly by aeroplane, reach there, and I'll stay there for 10 days and have swimming pool and the luxury of eating in the 5-star hotel, you know, moving by plane from city to city. What is this? What the hell? You are living in a state of fantasy land. That is called an imaginary land, which is not there. Heaven, in almost all religion, you know, the good people who were the earliest proponent of religion. Mind you children, religion, somebody has said, religion is the opium of the state. No one else than Karl Marx himself. It's jare. Kuch log opium ko jaise khate hai to unke upar nasa sa chha jata hai. Abhi bhi hamare desh mein dekh lo. The religious proselytization, conversion, jihad, love jihad, ये सब डिफरेंट वर्जन ऑफ एक्सप्लेनेशन आती है to propagate and spread their religious fervor. So the concept of heaven is there. जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि पाकिस्तान में टेररिस्ट को जो ट्रेनिंग दी जाती है, कोई नहीं मरना चाहता, हर किसी को प्राण बहुत प्यारा होता है, लेकिन उन बच्चों को, गरीब घर के बच्चों को पकड़ा जाता है, उनको ब्रेन वॉश की जाती है। अब बताया जाता है कि यदि तुम मर जाते हो अल्लाह के नाम पे, अपने कौम की बढ़ोतरी करते हुए, तो ऊपर जाओगे ना, ऊपर में कोई बैठा हुआ है, तो अबली अल्लाह, एंड देर आर 72 हूर्स। वट इज हूर? ब्यूटिफुल गर्ल्स वेटिंग फॉर यू टू मेक फ्रेंड्स विथ यू। वॉट ए ब्लडी नॉनसेंस। But people are spreading this kind of rumor openly on the TV. We had seen some of these stupid people like Jakir Nayak and all. They openly mocking at someone else's faith and try to eulogize and promote his own dirty version. What are these? These are all fantasizing and eulogizing, making heroes of something which is not existent. That is also a process of religious proselytization, forced conversion of their scheme of thinking. Lotus land, never never land, lotus land, kamal khila hua, uske upar koi makan bana hua hai aur usme main reh raha hu, kisi cheez ki kami nahi hai, everything has been given by God. Kabhi kabhi dekhte ho na, बच्चे बहुत बड़े बड़े सपने देखते हैं, यार 10th पास कर लूंगा, 12th पास कर लेंगे, उसके बाद IAS का एग्जाम देंगे, हो जाएगा, कभी कलेक्टर लग जाएंगे, कभी कमिश्नर लग जाएंगे, फिर जब रिटायर करेंगे सरकार मुझे गवर्नर तो बना ही देगी, और यदि गवर्नर ने बना दिया तो किसी कंट्री का एम्बेसडर तो बना ही देगा, और नहीं होगा तो मेरा चेहरा देखने के बाद मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट तो मैं बनूंगा नहीं, जब भी बनूंगा तो कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर बनूंगा, लंबी लंबी फेंकना, पता चला कि वो बाद में क्लर्क का एग्जाम भी पास करने लायक नहीं है। So that is called fantasizing. You are living in a state of fantasy. Nirvana. Buddhism के अंदर एक word दिया गया है, इसको English में बोलते हैं enlightenment, the final salvation, and that is also termed as Nirvana. That is also utopian concept. Nobody has seen that. If you ask the proponents and the followers of Buddhism, they will say that Mahatma Buddha had attained Nirvana, maybe, but he didn't come back to tell us where is the final state of Nirvana. It is a follower who has propounded this theory and this concept, and they are spreading their feelings. How can we say, who are living a normal life, we can do just good things? How can I say about myself that I have achieved or you are going to achieve Nirvana? That's a concept, and that's a feeling, and that's an explanation which is propounded by believer of some faith. So the state of Nirvana belongs to one sect of religion which is a part of Hinduism, now called Buddhism. Nirvana, paradise, swarg, vai swarg, promised land, Shangri-La. Shangri-La is what? Somebody has created a fictional story of a palace in North Atlantic, all valleys, the flowers, you know, all kinds of milk is flowing like a river, that kind of fictional story is created. That is, Shangri-La is full of that, mythical stories. So mind you, we are discussing something related to utopia, which is non-existent, and kind of imaginary feeling which is non-existent, but you are trying to glorify it and take pleasure out of it. So that is called utopian concept, utopian feeling, utopian concept. So more words related to utopia like dreamland, dream world, fairyland, wonderland, blissedness, blish, blissfulness, euphoria. Now let me explain what is the euphoria. Euphoria, it is only the euphoria that somebody, after somebody's, you know, brainwashing, comes to the stage taking that toting guns in his hand and is ready to sacrifice his so precious life to achieve which he has not achieved in this life, but he is promised that he would be achieving in different world. That is a euphoria, overexcitement, to achieve something which is non-existent, which is just part of propaganda. Mind you, I am explaining you the meaning of the word utopia. So I believe this word is clear. Now let us look some more phrases. Garden of Edens. Ek aisa, ek gana hai na, chand se mehbooba ho, aisa maine socha tha. Ab jo chand pe gaye hain, wo batate hain ki chand looks very dirty. लेकिन यहां से चांद किसी को दिखाई नहीं पड़ता, सारा हीरो हीरोइन को चांद की तरह तुलना कर देता है. बट चांद इज वेरी डर्टी, फुल ऑफ डस्ट, फुल ऑफ माउंटेनस रॉक्स. इफ यू लुक एट चांद, चांद मीन्स चंद्रमा, मून, दैट्स नॉट अ ब्यूटिफुल प्लेस. बट एवरीबडी कंपेयर्स विद चांद, चंदा मामा दूर के, बुआ पकावे गुड़ के, अपने खाए थाली में, बबुआ को खिलावे प्याली में, है ना, हर कुछ चंदा मामा. बिकॉज चंदा मामा हैज बीन, यू नो, इट कैन बी सीन विथ योर नेकेड आइज एंड इट इज नॉट एज प्लेसिड एंड हॉट रिडन एज सन. यू कैन सी इट विथ योर नेकेड आइज इन द कूल डार्क नाइट, द मूनलाइट नाइट. सो एवरीबडी कंपेयर्स मून एज ए सिंबल ऑफ ब्यूटी विच इज नॉट देयर. Near antonyms, now let us see antonyms for utopia. That was what? Shangri-La. That was what? Camelot, Cochrane, Eden, Elysium, all palace where nothing is in a scarcity, everything in the opulence. Iska antonyms kya hoga? Fool's paradise. Go to bloody shit. Go to bloody hell. You are living in a fool's paradise. That's the opposite of the word utopia. But the most beautiful word which comes as antonyms for the word utopia is dystopia. D-Y-S-T-O-P-I-A, dystopia. Just imagine medieval period. For that matter, the period which Mughals had reign in India, especially Aurangzeb and Tipu Sultan. Lakhs and lakhs of Hindus were killed, they were butchered, mayhem, forced conversion. What was that? It was a life of hell. And what was the motive of doing that? Religious proselytization. But certain segment of the people, they say that was the best period for them, for the spread of their religion. Maybe something bad for others could be good for sadists. So the dystopia, medieval period. Just imagine, my dear children, if you have studied, you must have studied in general studies or 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th civics books. Proletariat and bourgeois. Proletariat. Proletariat are the same people which were known as Spartan in the Athenians, Athens culture. Proletariat, who lived very meager life, very starving life, life of, you know, always wantedness, life of peasants, serfs. And the on contrary, it was the life of bourgeois. Bourgeois means, while I explained you the Industrial Revolution, I just gave you a word, bourgeois and proletariat, the laissez-faire economy. Laissez-faire economy means, leave me alone, there is no need of a state to regulate any of the mechanism. We are sufficient and more capable to look for our own welfare and for the people. So with the spread of laissez-faire economy, there also led to a rise of bourgeois and proletariat segments in the society, which we normal parlance call haves and have-nots. What are the haves? Those who have money. Have-nots? Those who don't have money. So utopia is a place, it's a noun, it's a state, imaginary state, where nothing is in existence, but and a state of thinking where everything is goody-goody, nothing is in disarray. So opposite is hell. Utopia, imagining something for a beautiful heaven. The opposite shall be dirty hell. So my dear children, you should not be under the impression, under the utopian concept that without laboring hard, you will get success. You must study hard to get success. Thank you very much.
Yada yada hi dharmasya glanirbhavati bharata abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam srijamyaham paritranaya sadhuna vinashaya cha dushkritam dharma sansthapanartha.